let's talk about density. Some of you may have heard of density or have kind of an idea of what you think it means. Scientifically, density is how much mass is in a volume of a substance. So when we talk about mass and volume, we're talking about number of atoms in an amount of space. Mass is measured in the metric system with unit grams. We can also use milligram or kilogram for little or big. Volume is measured in liters. We can also use milliliters and kiloliters. A milliliter is the same measurement as a centimeter cubed. You can see my little friend here. He takes up a milliliter of space, centimeter cubed of space. They're the same amount of space in the metric system. That's how they figured out what a milliliter was. It's the same thing as a centimeter by a centimeter by a centimeter. So many reasons the metric system is amazing. When we look at mass and volume, let's say we have 10 milliliters of space is my box, and I have 10 grams in there. Now, I can have the same amount of space, 10 milliliters, and put 5 grams inside. I can also have 10 milliliters of space, put 20 grams inside. And you can see how much more full of stuff the 20-gram box looks than the 5-gram box. So as we increase the mass of an object, we increase the density so long as we keep the same volume. If the volume were to increase as well, then that might not necessarily be the case. But if the volume is the same and the mass goes up, we get an increase in density. Now let's take another situation. We have the same thing, 10 grams and 10 milliliters of space. Now let's put those same 10 grams in 5 milliliters of space, half the space. Look how much more packed that box seems. And if we take that same 10 grams and put it in 20 milliliters of space, look how unpacked it looks. So if we keep our mass the same, but we increase our volume, then we decrease how dense it is. We could go the other direction as well, that if we decrease the volume, that we increase the density. So we take our mass and shove it into a smaller space or give it more space, we can change the density of the object. Density is a proportional relationship between mass and volume. So what we just saw there with our little boxes was my sneaky way of getting you to see the math. So it's the amount of mass in a volume, also mass divided by volume. So we're going to be using the formula density equals mass divided by volume a lot over the next few days. Density also has very specific units. But if we see these units next to a number, we know we're talking about a density. So because it's mass divided by volume, we can have grams over milliliters. We could also have kilograms over kiloliters, or milligrams over milliliters, or centigrams over centimeters cubed, or grams over centimeters cubed, or kilograms over meters cubed, or kilograms over liters, or centigrams over liters. It could go wherever we want to. Basically, we wind up with any mass over any volume unit will give us a density unit. Grams per milliliter, grams per centimeter cubed are going to be our good friends for the purposes of this class. But if we see anything else where there's a mass slash volume, we know it's a density. We can also calculate density for anything if we know the mass and the volume. So here's an aluminum block, and I did some measurements. So density equals mass divided by volume. Our mass is 42.18 grams, and our volume is 15.62 centimeters cubed. We divide those, mass divided by volume, we get 2.7 grams per centimeters cubed. That is the density of that block. That means there's 2.7 grams in every cubic centimeter. Now I have a little baby wood block. Density equals mass divided by volume. I have a master's degree, and I always write out M over V so I can keep my stuff straight. So 0.6 grams is his mass over 1 cubed centimeter. 0.6 grams per centimeters cubed is his density, much lower than that aluminum block. Now, how about two blocks. So if I take two of these little blocks, right, if one has a mass of 0.6 grams per milliliter, then two blocks have to have a density of 1.2 grams per milliliter, right? Wrong! The density of two blocks, mass over volume, our mass doubled, but so did our volume. So now we have 1.2 divided by 2, which still gives us 0.6 grams per milliliter. The density stays the same because the mass and the volume increase together. That's that proportional relationship thing. Density, because it's a proportional relationship, is also a constant for a substance, which means it always stays the same for any chunk of that substance. Because if we have a small piece of that substance, the mass is small and so is the volume. But the bigger the piece gets, the mass increases by the same amount that the volume increases every time. So when we calculate that density, it's always going to be the same number. Now, aluminum of any size block is always going to have the density of 2.7 grams per centimeter cubed. And maple, which is what that little wood block was, of any size, is always going to have a density of 0.6 grams per milliliter cubed. If we have a giant tree of maple, it's still going to be 0.6 grams per centimeter because it's going to have a giant mass and a giant volume. Density is a relationship. Now we know that. Check. We know that density can be calculated with mass divided by volume. Check. We know not only is it a relationship of mass and volume, it's a proportional relationship. Check. We know that density has units at the end of the numbers of grams per milliliter, grams per centimeters cubed are our common ones we're going to see in class. Check. And lastly, we know that density is a constant for a substance, so no matter how much of it we have, it's always the same.